Excel sheet I have given on the Telegram group. Anyways, so let us start today's class without wasting further time. So the first question on your screen, and you have 40 seconds. The time starts now. Twenty seconds left. Everyone, please answer. Five seconds left. 2 seconds, one, and most of you have given the correct answer. Very happy. I am so happy. Chaliye. So the answer to this question is, you can see. Option C, that is a Japan, right? Give me a second. So this is basically the summit of G20, which was held in the year of 2019 in Japan, Osaka, right? So if we see, there are three groupings: the G7, the G8. And the G20. Okay, so G7 was the starting point. G7 was constituted as a grouping of seven industrialized countries in 1970s, which included Germany, UK, France, Canada, USA, Italy, and Japan was also part of the G7 group, right? So from Asia it was Japan. And then we had the members from the Europe, which included Italy, France, UK, and Germany. And then we had Canada and the USA, right? From the North America. Give me a second. My notepad is not working. Yeah, after that, later on, the Russia was added to this grouping in 1998. So from G7 it became G8, but again in 2014 when Russia annexed the Crimea, jab Russia ne Crimea ko annex kiya, the Russia was removed from the grouping, right? So as of now, we have the G7 grouping. The G8 is not active. Although in 2018, USA expressed a willingness to restart the including the Russia into the G7. Right? This G20, it was formed after the 2008 financial crisis. Right? In 2008, we had USA subprime crisis. Right? So in this crisis, because of the fall of the real estate market ke fall ki wajah se the entire USA financial institutions crashed. The big institutions like Lehman Brothers, jo bade bade institutions the, wo crash kar gaye. The impact was rippling all around the world, including India and other developing countries. So at that point of time, all the important countries, the developed as well as the developing countries, right? So this G7 had only developed countries. G7 ke andar sirf developed countries the, and primarily this G7 started as a political body. This started as a political body after there was oil crisis in 1973, right? But this G20 started more as a financial cooperation platform, right? Monetary and financial cooperation platform. Although as of now, both of them are discussing a wide array of topic. आज के समय में तो ये एक ब्रॉड एरे ऑफ टॉपिक को डिस्कस करते हैं, ठीक है। इन G20 इंडिया इज ऑल्सो ए मेंबर, इंडिया इज अ मेंबर, राइट, इंडिया इज अ मेंबर ऑफ द G20, इंडिया इज नॉट ए मेंबर ऑफ द G7 और G8 कैटेगरी, ठीक है। यू कैन सी G7 वाज सेट अप इन 1975 आफ्टर द 1973 ऑयल क्राइसिस एंड इट इज अ ग्रुपिंग ऑफ लीडिंग वर्ल्ड इंडस्ट्रियल नेशंस। It is an informal bloc which had 7 members. It meets annually to discuss the various issues about the governance, economic governance, international security, energy policy. In 1998, the Russia joined, but it was kicked out in 2014 after the annexation of the Crimea. Right. So, for a brief period of time, this G7 became the G8. But now, after 2014, now it is again back as the G7. The 2019 summit was held in French town Biarritz, and it was presided over by the France. The focus was on fighting the inequality. Okay. So the theme was inequality. In the examination, they can ask a theme. Ki what was the theme of 2019 G7 summit? The major 5 objectives included gender equality, environmental inequality, globalization, acting for peace, tapping into the opportunities created by the digital technology and artificial intelligence, right? So the overall Shubhajit, please don't type in between, because that distracts me, that distracts other people also, right? If I ask some question, then please respond. Otherwise, I know that you are very intelligent. Please don't intervene. Okay, thank you very much. So, coming back, yeah. So there are 5 objectives. So one thing you have to keep in mind: these 5 objectives are across various topics. It includes gender. It includes environment. It includes globalization. It includes security. That is a peace. And it includes technology, right? So this platform is not limited to just politics or economics. It is the range is all across the various subjects. So in the examination, you can get a question where they will be asking in which area this G7 is working. So you have to keep in mind that there is a wide range of topic where this G20 is working. Okay. Now, G7. In 2020, the summit was scheduled to take place in Camp David, United States, and Now, it will be held through the video conference. Okay. So you will find the news after 2 weeks. So after 2 weeks, you will find the news about G7. G20, it is an informal group of 19 countries. Please keep in mind, 19 countries plus EU. That is how it has total 20 members. It has the representatives of the IMF and World Bank also. IMF or World Bank representatives bhi yahan par hai. It started after the 2008 financial crisis. The first summit was in the Washington. So there can be a question in the prelims about the first summit. Okay. So prelims exam mein wo first summit bhi pooch lete hain kai baar. The meeting is held annually, and formally this G20 meeting, the summit, the name of the summit is Financial Markets and the World Economy. The summit on the financial markets and the world economy. So you have to keep in mind that this is the formal name of the G20 summit, which is held annually. The first summit was held in the Washington. Members, we have already seen. So EU is one member, right? EU is one member, and from within the EU, there are various countries like France, Germany, which are also the member, right? There is no permanent staff. The presidency is rotating every year. And the recent summit was held in Osaka, Japan, which had 8 themes ranging from economy, trade and investment, innovation, environment, energy, employment, women's empowerment, development, health. So again, you can see the range of the topic is very wide. In 2020, the summit is scheduled to take place in the month of November 2020 in the country of Saudi Arabia, in the location of Riyadh, right? So in next year, it will be like this year, this will be held in the Riyadh. The answer to the question is Osaka, Japan, option C. Any doubt? Now, there was a news that this US is asking for changing the WTO rules about granting the developing countries status for the China and India. So China and India, they're the next big thing to happen in the world. They are the largest emerging countries. Their economic growth rate is highest in the world, right? So USA is saying that China and India should no longer be classified as the developing countries for the WTO, right? So in case of WTO, if some country is a developing country, such country gets various benefits. Usko kuch benefits milte hain which are not available to the developed countries. So USA is saying, especially for the China, that China is now a very big size country. Its economy is very, very strong. So it should be categorized as the developed countries rather than the developing countries, right? So how does this status is granted? Who grants the status? So WTO members, they themselves can classify into developed or developing country. So each country can classify itself as a developing country or as a developed country. However, if someone has classified itself as a developing country, in that case, if some country has been classified as a developing country, other members, they can challenge the decision of that particular country. And the least developed countries status is given by the United Nations. Okay. So there are three grouping. One is developing countries, second is developed countries, and the third one is least developed countries. So developing and developed are based on the declaration made by the countries themselves. So India ne bola ki main developing hu, USA ne bola ki main developed hu, to WTO maan leta hai. Lekin agar developing country ka status milta hai, koi claim karna chahta hai, to us claim ko challenge kiya ja sakta hai. Theek hai? Least developed countries ka jo status hai, that will be given by the United Nations. Ye kon dega? Ye United Nations ka jo criteria hota hai, us criteria ke basis par least developed country ka status milega. Because the least developed country ka status hai, isko bahut zyada benefit available hote hain. Theek hai? Inko bahut zyada benefit available hote hain. Isliye ye jo darja hai, isko hum self declaration basis par nahi allow karte. In this category we have Afghanistan, Bangladesh, Bhutan, Myanmar, Nepal, South Sudan, etc. So you can see who are the developing countries in WTO. There is no WTO definition. The members, they can announce themselves and other members can challenge if someone claims as a developing country. What are the advantages for the developing country? It ensures special and differential treatment. So we will discuss about special and differential treatment in this session only after some time. What is the meaning of special and differential treatment? So you will get to understand about that also. Okay. Now developed countries are demanding that the benefits which are given to the developing countries, they should be ended. Ab unko khatam kar dena chahiye. The 2/3 of the members, they are claiming themselves to be the developing or LCD countries, least developed countries. So 2/3 countries jo hai, wo apne aap ko developing country या लीस्ट डेवलप कंट्री क्लेम करके मैक्सिमम बेनिफिट वो लेके चले जाते हैं। इसलिए हम बोल रहे हैं कि द डेवलप कंट्रीज बोल रहे हैं कि जो बेनिफिट उनको दिए जाते हैं वो खत्म कर दिए जाए। नाउ क्वेश्चन ऑन योर स्क्रीन, सो यू हैव 30 सेकेंड्स स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम नाउ। आई वॉन्ट द आंसर फ्रॉम एवरी वन इन दीज 30 सेकेंड्स, ठीक है? एवरीवन प्लीज, सो यू हैव 5 सेकेंड्स लेफ्ट, टाइम इज ओवर। आई एम सो हैप्पी 13 आउट ऑफ 15 हैव गिवन द आंसर, वेरी वेरी गुड, wonderful, and most of you have given the right answer, that is the option B, right? So option B is the correct answer. India has signed a loan agreement for the KS program with the Asian Development Bank, right? So this KS fund basically means COVID-19 active response and expenditure support program. This ADB, it was established in 1966, headquarters is in Manila, Philippines, and it is an official UN observer. It admits the member of United Nations Economic and Social Commission for the Asia and Pacific and the non-regional developed countries also. Okay. So the member can be non-regional developed country like USA and other countries. So the answer is option B, Asian Development Bank. Now this is very, very important question. Please read this question carefully and then give the answer. Through this question, I will discuss important aspects of the WTO topic. So WTO topic is both important. I will discuss some important points from there. The time starts now. For this question, you will get 45 seconds. The question is little bit tricky. Your time starts now, 45 seconds. Ten seconds are left. Everyone, please give the answer. 5 seconds are left. 4, 3, 2, 1, and only 11 people give the answer. But most of you have given the correct answer. Very, very good. Competition is increasing. Students are so prepared. Very good. Wonderful. The answer is option C only. We will discuss in detail after some time. Next question on your screen. Again, for this question, you will find 45 seconds. Your time starts now. So take 35 seconds for deciding and 10 seconds for marking the question. Seconds left, 15 seconds left, 10 seconds, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Okay, very good. Most of you have given the answer, and the correct answer is in minority. Okay, good. Answer is option A. because in the option three, in the statement three, the decision is not final, right? Because this decision of the General Council can be challenged at the WTO appellate board. ठीक है, तो appellate board होता है जहां पर इस decision को challenge किया जा सकता है. ठीक है, now let us discuss some important points about the WTO. This topic is very very important for the examination. That is why I will like to discuss some important aspects about the WTO. ठीक है, any questions so far? आपका कोई question है तो आप पूछ सकते हो. चलिए, so WTO, first of all, it is not a part of the United Nations. Lavish, you can type the question in the chat box if you have some question. चलिए, so WTO is not a part of the United Nations. Please mark this very very important for the examination. WTO is not a part of the United Nations. Please keep in mind this thing. ठीक है, so give me a second. चलिए, the voting system is based on one country one vote. ठीक है, one country one vote होता है इसके अंदर. So there are total 164 countries. Each country has one vote. Unlike in case of IMF and World Bank, where the decision making is based on the quota system. ठीक है, तो वहां पर voting right अलग अलग countries के अलग अलग होते हैं. But in case of WTO, the voting rights are equal. सबके voting rights बराबर होते हैं. ठीक है, WTO it gives World Trade Report every year. The highest decision making body of the WTO is Ministerial Conference. So if we see the organizational structure of the WTO, this MC is the highest decision making body. The decisions of the WTO are taken through the consensus. Consensus के through decisions होते हैं, and this consensus is achieved through informal negotiations, which is called green room negotiation. ठीक है, so if you find the term green room negotiation or mini ministerial, that is nothing but informal negotiation. So for example, suppose India is not agreeing on the e-commerce provisions of the WTO. Suppose India e-commerce के ऊपर agree नहीं कर रहा है, so the countries which are supporting India on, and the countries which are on the other side, that is supporting the e-commerce, both of them will sit together. They will hand small meetings. They will try to reach out the common consensus, and then only the final decision will be taken at the WTO level. So that is called green room negotiation, so that any point of disagreement can be given a green signal after the consensus is reached. So in the examination you can find the word green room negotiation, and you have to understand that this is basically part of the WTO informal negotiation. India conducted two mini ministerials in 2018 and 2019. This WTO was established in 1995. It replaced the General Agreement on the Trade and it replaced the General Agreement on Trades and Tariffs. ठीक है, so this GATT, it was simply an agreement. ये simple एक agreement था about the free and fair trade. But this WTO is an organization. ये एक organization है. O means organization. So this WTO, it gave the institutional form to the agreement. The headquarters is in Geneva, Switzerland. It is headed by Director General who is there for 4 years. The term is renewable. As of now, we have Roberto Azevedo, who is basically given the extension again in 2017. There are total 164 members. India is the founding member. WTO represents 98% of the world trade. That is a very big thing. The latest member to add in the WTO was Afghanistan. EU is also a member. Okay? So EU is a member of the G20 also. EU is a member of WTO also. Okay? And a WTO member must be a custom territory with full autonomy in conduct of external commercial relations. They may not be the full sovereign nations. Therefore, Hong Kong and Taiwan are also the WTO members. Right? So Hong Kong and Taiwan, they don't have the full sovereign rights, but still they are part of the WTO because they are the custom territory. Okay? If we see organizational structure, in the top we have ministerial conference. This ministerial conference is basically attended by ministers of commerce and the trade of all the member states. It meets every 2 years. The first conference was held in Singapore. The fourth conference was held in Doha, right? So first conference is important. Fourth conference is important because of this Doha round. You know, it was held to resolve many pending issues, right? In 2017, it was held in Buenos Aires in Argentina. And this time it will be held in Astana, Kazakhstan in 2020. Okay? Next part of the structure is General Council. ठीक है, so top में हमारा Ministerial Conference था, second number पे हमारा General Council है. General Council is attended by the ambassadors and it works. Please keep in mind, it works as the dispute settlement body. ये dispute settlement body की तरह काम करता है. The second point is the trade. It acts as the trade policy review body also. The third component is Council for Trade, which has three different council: Council for Trade in Goods, Council for Trade in Services, and Council for Trade in the trade related aspect of IPR. Then we have different committees and workshops. Okay, so you have to remember, in the top we have Ministerial Conference. And second, we have this General Council, which also acts as the dispute settlement body. Now, there are three important principles of the WTO. Teen important principles in WTO. Okay? So, hum isko padhte hain, kya kya important principles hai WTO ke. So, anyone who would like to tell me what are the three important principles of WTO, kon batana chahega? You can type in the chat box. Who would like to tell me the three principles of WTO? You can type in the chat box. Okay, Shubhajit. Anyone else? I'm giving you 30 seconds. Take your time. Rahul, please give the answer in the private chat box, not for everyone, because in that case, other people, they get distracted. Okay, your answer is correct. So the answer is, there are three principles: MFN, national treatment, and the special provisions. Okay, so we have MFN, jiske bare mein humne last class mein baat ki thi. The first principle is most favored nation category. So all the WTO member, they automatically get MFN status. What is the meaning of MFN status? Suppose there are different countries. We have India, we have China, USA, we have France, we have Canada, right? India, suppose India grants some special favor to the Canada. India says that for the export to the Canada, I am giving special incentive to the exporter. In that case, the same incentive must be extended to the China, USA, and France export also. So any advantage, any favor or advantage has to be granted to all the other WTO members. So the same trade conditions have to be maintained. There cannot be any discrimination between its trading partners. ठीक है? So this is the meaning of most favored nation. All the WTO members, they automatically get the MFN status from all the other WTO members. ठीक है? तो जितने भी एडवांटेज कोई भी WTO member दूसरी कंट्री को देगा उतने ही एडवांटेज मुझे भी मिलेंगे. ये हर एक WTO member को पता होता है. ठीक है? But there are some exceptions. कुछ exceptions हैं. The first exception is the regional economic integrations. So we have various organizations like ASEAN, NAFTA, European Union, SAFTA, etc. So there is a special agreement between the different countries. So you can also include RCEP. ठीक है? तो इन सब में most favored nation concept applicable नहीं होता. Right? Special access to the developing countries. Developing countries के लिए special कुछ access allowed हो सकता है. Third, whenever a country feels that some other country is trading unfairly, कुछ extra unfair advantage दिया जा रहा है किसी दूसरी country को, or some other country is exploiting the rules and regulation, in that case also the MFN status can be withdrawn. And the fourth is under the security exception clause. For example, for Pakistan, India withdrew in 2019 the MFN status. So this thing we discussed in the last class very very clearly. The second principle is national treatment. The second principle kya hota hai? National treatment. What is the meaning of national treatment? National treatment means, national treatment ka matlab kya hota hai? Suppose in India we have two type of companies. One is the Reliance company, which is an Indian company. Another is Walmart, which is a foreign company. So if the rate of tax on the Reliance is 30%, we cannot charge high rate of tax from the Walmart and for other terms and conditions also, right? So the rules and regulation have to be same for domestic country as well as foreign country. So that will give the parity to the domestic and as well as the foreign countries. This is the meaning of national treatment. However, in the context of national treatment, there have been in news. This concept has been in news because on the one hand, USA filed a case against India that in India, in the national solar mission, India ne national solar mission start kiya tha. In that mission, India inserted a clause that any project must have 30% of the domestic content. Yani ke agar solar cells koi national solar mission ke andar procure ki jati hai, so that solar cell should have 30% content from India. The purpose was to give the growth to the domestic solar cells and the module manufacturing industry. But the USA said that this is violative of the national treatment. You are giving the special treatment to the domestic countries, which is against the national treatment. The India lost this case in 2016 and it was upheld by the WTO appellate board also. ठीक है? So India ने ये जो केस है ये हार गया. India ये केस हार गया 2016 में. Same thing was done by the USA, right? Same चीज USA ने start की. ठीक है? In the USA, 8 American states they started giving renewable energy subsidies and local content requirement, right? And India filed against that. India ने उसके against case file किया and India won that case against the USA in 2019, right? So because of these two cases, this national treatment clause is in news. In cases की वजह से national treatment जो clause होती है वो news में रहती है and उसी की वजह से आपका ये जो appellate body है ये भी आपके news में रहती है. ठीक है? So these are the two cases which happened about the national treatment. The third principle is special and differential treatment with the developing countries. right? Special and differential treatment with the developing countries. So the first principle was MFN. Second principle was national treatment. The third principle is special and differential treatment. The name itself suggests that we are giving some special treatment or differential treatment for the developing countries. It can be in terms of that they will be allowed more time to fulfill any obligation, or they will be allowed more market access, or they will be allowed some provisions like anti-dumping, safeguard or technical barrier. ठीक है, तो इस तरह की कुछ चीजें उनको specially allowed कर दी जाती है. Now at this point of time, I would like to discuss this term anti-dumping. Countervailing and safeguard duty. So what is the difference between the three? तीनों के बीच में difference क्या है? So we normally hear this term anti-dumping duty, countervailing duty, safeguard duty. What is the difference between the three? Do you have the idea? Say yes in the chat box if you have the idea. And you can say no if you don't have the idea. Both ways you can answer, but I would be happy if you answer so that I can know the response of the class. Okay, so I can see most of you are saying no. I will discuss this in little bit detail for your benefit. Anti-dumping duty. So, Lavish, are you watching the lecture on the mobile? आप मोबाइल पे देख रहे हो लेक्चर को? If you are watching the lecture on the mobile, then you should keep the mobile in the horizontal format. ठीक है? Keep like this. Don't keep like this. If you keep like this, then you can see the screen size is reduced. ठीक है ना, कितना छोटा हो गया. If you keep like this, screen size is 100%. ठीक है. Now is it visible clearly? चलिए. Anti-dumping. So suppose in China, we have a company called Redmi. ठीक है. This company want to capture the handset market of India. India के जो mobile handset market है उसको capture करना चाहते हैं. Their cost of production of one mobile is suppose 5,000 rupees. कॉस्ट ऑफ प्रोडक्शन उनकी 5,000 रुपीज है. इन इंडिया द सिमिलर मोबाइल इज बीइंग मैन्युफैक्चर्ड बाय सपोज सैमसंग, एंड सैमसंग इज सेलिंग दिस प्रोडक्ट एज 10,000 रुपीज. नाउ दिस रेडमी कंपनी टू कैप्चर द मार्केट ऑफ इंडिया, इट विल स्टार्ट सेलिंग दिस प्रोडक्ट इन टू इंडियाज मार्केट. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, this Redmi mobile is being sold in at 10,000 rupees in China. China mein 10,000 rupees ka sale kiya ja raha hai. The same product is being sold at 5,000 rupees in India. India mein ye 5,000 rupees ka sale kiya ja raha hai. Theek hai? Or in many cases even below the cost of production, that is the 4,000 rupees. So here in India the customer will start buying the Redmi phone because it is cheaper, but the rates are the quality is equal. So in the medium to long term, this Samsung would be adversely affected. The domestic country, the domestic company will be adversely affected. The domestic manufacturing facility would be adversely affected. So this will actually demolish the domestic industry. So to prevent this kind of situation, India, the Indian government would levy the anti-dumping duty, that is the kind of import duty. So in this case, the import duty of 5,000 rupees will be levied. 5,000 rupees ki import duty levy ki jayegi, so that the cost of this product, this becomes 10,000 rupees in India, which is equal to the domestic manufacturer. So in this way, anti-dumping duty saves the domestic industry. इस तरह से इंडस्ट्री को, डोमेस्टिक इंडस्ट्री को हम लोग सेव कर सकते हैं. द सेकेंड इज काउंटरवेलिंग ड्यूटी. द सेकेंड इज काउंटरवेलिंग ड्यूटी. सो इन द काउंटरवेलिंग ड्यूटी, सपोज दिस इज चाइना, दिस इज इंडिया, द कॉस्ट ऑफ प्रोडक्शन ऑफ एनी आइटम इन चाइना इज 10,000 रुपीज. Suppose this is a laptop. The cost of production is 10,000 rupees. In India, the same laptop is being sold at, suppose, 15,000 rupees. ठीक है? Now, in case of anti-dumping, the country was interested in capturing the market. The company, the Redmi, was interested in capturing the market, but there was no support available from the side of Chinese government. In this case, the Chinese government is saying, Chinese government bolti hai ki I will give you the export incentive. Main aapko export incentive dunga agar aap is product ko India mein sasta sell karte ho. So you start selling this product in India at 10,000 rupees and you take 5,000 rupees from me. You can treat this as the profit. आप इसको profit के तरह treat कर सकते हो और इस product को आप India में 10,000 rupees में sale करना शुरू कर दो, right? So this incentive or subsidy, this is given from the side of Chinese government. Now this 10,000 rupees product will actually hamper the sale of the 15,000 product of India's company. So in this case, Indian government will levy the countervailing duty. It is again a import duty, that when this product is imported, the 5,000 rupees will be levied. So the cost of this product will become 15,000, and this product of India and China, they will be having the same price. So in case of anti-dumping, the government support is not available from the exporting country. Exporting country ki taraf se koi bhi support available nahi hoti. In case of countervailing duty, exporting country is giving the subsidy to the exporting company. ठीक है? So this is the major difference between the anti-dumping and the countervailing duty. Now, another is safeguard duty. तीसरा होता है आपका safeguard duty. This safeguard duty, this is used whenever any importing country feels that there is unusually high quantity of import. There is unusually high quantity of import of any product from any particular country. किसी particular product का किसी particular country से unusually high quantity of import हो रहा है. And this is adversely impacting. So please keep in mind, not only there is high import, but it must also adversely impact the domestic country. Ye domestic country ko bhi, domestic company ko bhi adversely impact kar raha hai. In that case, if both of these conditions are satisfied, then Indian government can impose the import duty, which is called the special safeguard duty. So the meaning of the word duty in this case is tax. So duty ka matlab kya hota hai? Tax. Theek hai? Is it clear everyone? Now let us come back. So we have discussed anti-dumping, countervailing and safeguard duty. Now so we discussed MFN, national treatment, and special and differential treatment. Special and differential treatment, a Under this, there is a special system which is called general system of preferences. ठीक है, general system of preferences. This general system of preferences, this is a status which is given to any least developed country. जो किसी least developed country को available होता है. Who are the WTO members? In this preferential tariff system is given for which provides the scope for tariff reduction for the LDC by other WTO member. For example, USA had given the LDC status to India for its various product. So USA used to levy low rate of export duty on many product and low rate of import duty for many product. ठीक है. So the purpose was to increase the trade with India and allow more market access to the Indian companies. Under this GSP, there are two mechanism. One is special products. Second is special safeguards mechanism. So these were introduced for the Doha round and in the Doha round, but they were introduced only for the developing countries. ठीक है. ये जो स्पेशल प्रोडक्ट और स्पेशल सेफगार्ड मैकेनिज्म है, ये डेवलप कंट्रीज के लिए ही एप्लीकेबल थे, इन एडिशन टू द एलडीसी. डेफिनेटली स्पेशल प्रोडक्ट मींस दे आर द एग्रीकल्चरल कमोडिटीज ऑफ स्पेशल इंपोर्टेंस टू द फार्मिंग कम्युनिटी इन डेवलपिंग कंट्री. दस इट अलाउड इम्पोजिशन ऑफ हायर टैरिफ्स ऑन द स्पेशल प्रोडक्ट्स. सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल इन इंडिया, सपोज वी टेक द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ मैंगो. सो मैंगो इज it is of special importance. It provides the income to large number of farmers, right? So in case of import of mango, the high rate of tariff, high rate of import duty, import tax can be levied by the India. So that will protect India's mango growers. Wo India ke jo special product ke jo farmers hain, usko protect karenge. Theek hai. The second, we have a special safeguard mechanism under which the developing country, they can temporarily impose higher than bound tariff rate on the import of particular agricultural commodity, and this is allowed if there is a sudden surge in the import of product in the developing country member. So ye jo, this special safeguard, this is allowed in case of sudden surge. So this is basically nothing but a special safeguard duty which we already discussed in the previous discussion. Theek hai. So a special product, this is permanent provision. Special safeguard provision, this SSM is a temporary provision. Ye temporary provision. Apart from that, there are various agreements of the WTO. Agreement on agriculture, agreement on trade in textile and clothing, agreement on trims, agreement on trips, general agreement on trade in services. So all these are the things, and that will take a lot of time. Agar hum isko discuss karna start karenge, तो हमारा बहुत टाइम निकल जाएगा. इट विल अप्रोक्सीमेटली 1 आवर. सो आई नॉर्मली डिस्कस दिस टॉपिक इन माय पेड क्लासेस. यू कैन सी पेड क्लासेस में मैं इसको टॉपिक को पूरा अच्छे से डिस्कस करता हूं. आई डिस्कस यू कैन सी each and every agreement, but as of now I am discussing only current affairs. So I cannot discuss each and every topic in detail. So all these things I discuss in my paid classes only, because in the paid classes I am covering the complete syllabus. Wahan pe mera purpose hota hai foundation provide karna, current affairs, everything, right? So you get a 100% clarity, right? So ye achhe achhe webs ppts ke through main wahan par padhata hu. You can also take the advantage of that if you are feeling difficulty in economy. I am giving the course at a very low cost. Can you think of the cost? The market cost is around 12,000. Market mein same cost 12,000 ka milta hai. I am providing it 1500 rupees so that maximum number of people can get the benefit. Theek hai? The only purpose is to reach out to maximum number of people. The only purpose is to give the benefit to the maximum number of people, right? So you will get all these beautiful sessions with the previous year questions, everything. Many of you are part of my paid program, so you already know the quality of the paid program. All of the chapters, 100% syllabus is covered with sincerity, ठीक है, चलिए लेट अस कम बैक. So Rahul is asking, sir, please explain blue box subsidy, amber brick subsidy. So my friend, okay, let me tell you briefly about these subsidies. So basically, there is an agreement on agriculture. ठीक है, agriculture के ऊपर agreement है, the AOA. ठीक है. So out of the various agreement, this is one of the agreement. In this agreement, various countries, they provide the subsidies to their farmers. Farmers को सब्सिडी प्रोवाइड करते हैं. For example, in India, we have fertilizer subsidy, power subsidy, seed subsidy, right? Interest subvention, that is also kind of subsidy. We have the subsidy in the form of MSP, minimum support price. तो बहुत सारी तरह के subsidies farmers को provide करते हैं. Now Because of these subsidies, the cost of production of the agricultural commodities, it reduces. Agar cost of production kam hoti hai, when the same product is exported to the international market, then its international competitiveness increases. Iski jo international competitiveness hai, wo badh jati hai. And because of that, the other products, the product of other countries, they have some kind of disadvantage. So to control these subsidies, there is an upper limit which is kept on these subsidies. In subsidies ke upar upper limit rakhi jati hai. This upper limit is called aggregate measurement of support, AMS. And this is basically 10% of the value of agricultural production. ठीक है, तो agriculture production की जो value होती है उसका 10% तक ये subsidy maximum allow की जा सकती है. And this subsidy can be of three types. It can be of green box subsidy, it can be blue box, and it can be amber box. ठीक है, ग्रीन बॉक्स इज यू नो विच इज नॉट डिस्टोर्टिंग द मार्केट, जो मार्केट को डिस्टोर्ट नहीं कर रही है. देर इज नो अपर लिमिट इन केस ऑफ ग्रीन बॉक्स. द ब्लू बॉक्स इज देयर विच इज यू नो डिस्टोर्टिंग द मार्केट बट नॉट वेरी वेरी हाई. एंड दिस अमर बॉक्स इज समथिंग विच इज डिस्टोर्टिंग एट ए वेरी हाई लेवल, जिसका डिस्टोर्शन बहुत ज्यादा होता है. So the upper limit is kept especially for the amber box subsidy. Upper limit jo hoti hai uske liye amber box use kiya jata hai. There has been a dispute about this subsidy, right? There has been a dispute about India's MSP. Jo India ka jo MSP hota hai uske bare mein dispute raha hai. If we talk about this subsidy program, because of which this always remains in news. Ye kya ye problem hai? Let us see. So the government of India provides the minimum support price guarantee to the farmers. Farmers ko minimum support price guarantee provide ki jati hai, that if they are producing something and suppose for the wheat the MSP is 1000 rupees per quintal. If the farmer go to the market, in the market suppose the market price is 800 rupees per quintal, that is if the market price is lower than the MSP, then the farmer can go to the government of India, basically the FCI, Food Corporation of India, which is representing the government of India, and government of India will buy the wheat from the farmer. Theek hai? So in this case, indirectly the government of India has provided the subsidy to the farmer worth ₹200. So, 200 rupees ki subsidy India ne provide kar diya hai. Now India provides this subsidy for stabilizing the farmer income, jo income hoti hai usko stabilize karna hai, and it has to provide the food security also through the PDS program. PDS program ke through food security bhi provide karni hai, isliye bhi ye सब्सिडी प्रोवाइड की जाती है सो दैट मोर एंड मोर फार्मर्स कैन ग्रो दीज फूड ग्रेन्स एंड देर इज नो शॉर्टेज ऑफ द फूड ग्रेन इन द कंट्री. द प्राइमरी पर्पज इज नॉट टू डिस्टोर्ट द फॉरिन मार्केट, द पर्पज इज नॉट टू डिस्टोर्ट द एक्सपोर्ट मार्केट, द पर्पज इज बेसिकली टू कीप रनिंग द फार्मर्स इनकम एंड प्रोवाइड द फूड सिक्योरिटी टू द कंट्री थ्रू द पीडीएस सिस्टम. सो दिस इज द सिस्टम फॉलोड इन इंडिया. तो हुआ क्या, वॉट हैपन इन दिस केस, तो वॉट हैपन दिस MSP subsidy है, जो MSP support है, it was contested in the WTO. WTO में India के खिलाफ एक resolution लाया गया that this MSP support is very very high, that this MSP support is distorting the agricultural market, right? But India ने बोला कि first of all the purpose is not to distort the export market. एक्सपोर्ट मार्केट को डिस्टोर्ट करने का हमारा कोई पर्पस नहीं है, दिस इज ओनली फॉर द फूड सिक्योरिटी. सेकेंडली सेकेंड थिंग इज दैट द बेस ईयर विच वॉज यूज टू कैलकुलेट 10% अपर लिमिट, द बेस ईयर वॉज 1986-1987, ठीक है, 1986-1987 में जो आपने कुछ बेस ईयर डिसाइड किया था, कुछ बेस प्राइसेस डिसाइड किए थे, based upon that you are calculating the upper limit. But if we see from base year till now, that is 2000, so this matter arose in 2013-14, so during this period of around more than 27 years, there has been lot of inflation, bahut zyada inflation ho gaya hai, which has not been considered in the calculation of the this 10%, ठीक है? So accordingly this 10% limit, if we calculate from the inflation point of view, it will be increased. ये जो limit है हमारी, ये breach नहीं होगी, ठीक है? So this was the argument given by the India. Later on, the various countries accepted the argument of India. The peace clause was signed in the Bali के अंदर peace clause signed हुई थी, and India agreed to sign the trade facilitation agreement. In return of acceptance of this, argument of India. So this is about the subsidy. Right? So is it clear to everyone? Are you enjoying the session? Is it clear, everyone? Chaliye. Now, coming to the main point, WTO's dispute settlement mechanism. In the case of violation of WTO rule, तो WTO के जो रूल हैं, सपोज MFN और वी हैव नेशनल ट्रीटमेंट और वी हैव दिस स्पेशल सेफगार्ड मैकेनिज्म एटसेट्रा, कोई भी रूल हो सकता है, इफ देर इज अ वायलेशन द पार्टीज कैन गो फॉर द बायलेटरल कंसल्टेशन. पहले तो वो आराम से बैठ के बात करेंगे, राइट? इफ दैट कंसल्टेशन फेल्स, देन एनी ऑफ द पार्टी विद इन 60 डेज they can request the general counsel for the adjudication, right? This general counsel acts as the dispute settlement body. I already told you this general counsel acts as the dispute settlement body. If someone is not satisfied with the judgment of the dispute settlement body, then they can go to the appellate body of WTO, which is called WTO appellate body, WTO AB. ठीक है, सो दिस डीएसबी डिसीजन इज नॉट फाइनल, दिस इज नॉट फाइनल, ये फाइनल नहीं है, ठीक है, दिस इज नॉट फाइनल बिकॉज इट कैन बी चैलेंज्ड इन द WTO AB. WTO AB में अपहोल्ड, मॉडिफाई और रिवर्स द अर्लियर जजमेंट ऑफ द जनरल काउंसिल. ऑर्डर ऑफ WTO AB इज बाइंडिंग, ये बाइंडिंग होता है, ठीक है, ऑर्डर ऑफ DSB इज नॉट बाइंडिंग, इट कैन बी चैलेंज्ड. If the erring country does not follow the order, other countries allowed to take retaliatory measures. अगर erring country बात नहीं मानता है, तो उसको जेल में तो डाला नहीं जाएगा, ठीक है? ऐसे तो कुछ provision है नहीं WTO में कि अगर आप बात नहीं मानोगे appellate board की, तो आपको जेल में डाल दिया जाएगा. नहीं मानो, कोई बात नहीं मानता है, तो जो victim होता है, उसको बोलोगे कि आप उससे बदला ले लो, ठीक है? But ये बदले की जो भावना है, ये जो छोटे-छोटे country हैं, वो तो उनके लिए बड़ा मुश्किल हो जाएगा. They cannot, take the retaliation from the developed countries, right? So there is no punishment. There is no punishment, but the poor countries suffer because they cannot retaliate against the developed countries. If we see 2019 annual report, there have been 38 new disputes, and this annual number is highest since 1995. That is why this mechanism is in news. इसलिए ये हमारे लिए exam के लिए भी important हो जाती है. ठीक है. WTO appellate body was set up in 1995. It has 7 members. The order is so you can see the answer is both 1 and 2. WTO has appellate body. Dispute settlement body is the supreme body. And in this case, the answer is option 1 and 2 only, because decisions are not final and binding.